Students, now let's start with the new concept in shear force and bending moment diagram. So far we have confusion that how to make the bending moment diagram curve either convex or concave. So I will sort out that problem. How? Let's see. So you need to remember two equations. First is df by dx is equal to W, and another equation is dm by dx is equal to F. Now what is that meaning? Rate of change of shear force will be equal to the load intensity, and here rate of change of bending moment is equal to the shear force. So whenever you are drawing shear force diagram, so keep remember, slope in shear force diagram will be decided by the load diagram, that means by the beam diagram. So in the beam diagram, we will have some load intensity, varying load intensity. So how the shear force will be, as according to, we have to follow W, that means load condition. Similarly, while drawing the bending moment diagram, so bending moment diagram will be having which kind of slope, that will be decided by shear force diagram. So keep remember, shear force diagram will depend upon load conditions, and bending moment diagram will depend upon shear force diagram and variation of shear force. So let's start with how. So before starting main thing, so let I first tell you. Now if there is x and y, keep remember, if this is x and this is y, now what are the type of slope? See, if we draw a curve, suppose this kind of curve we have, okay. Now in this case, this is a point which is maximum point on the curve which will be having zero slope. Keep remember, here the slope is zero. Now the curve line which is on the left side of the section having positive slope, and the curve which is on the right side of this vertical section will be having negative slope. Okay, so keep remember, this one is positive slope, this is negative slope, and at the maximum point will have slope which is equal to zero. So this is how I will use positive slope, negative slope and zero slope parameters. Now next start with, so first, now we have done this problem. Now in this case, remember, so how shear force variation will be there? See, you can see between A and C there is no force, that means W is zero. So if W is zero, that means df by dx will be equal to zero. So if df by dx will be equal to zero, that means slope will be equal to zero in shear force diagram. So you can see here I have shown a line with zero slope. Okay, so this is how shear force diagram will changes. Now next come to the bending moment diagram. See, in bending moment diagram, so how bending moment diagram will be, we have to see the shear force diagram. Now during this portion, we can see the shear force is constant. Now we have equation dm by dx is equal to F. So while drawing bending moment diagram, we can see shear force is constant value. So if we get shear force constant, that means slope of bending moment will be again constant. Now we can see here we have positive shear force which is constant. So we have drawn a positive slope line with constant slope. Now here we have negative shear force which is constant. So we have drawn negative slope line. So this is how the conceptual things are there behind the shear force and bending moment diagram. So let's see another case. Now in this case, again the same variation is there. We can see the load is not given. So if W is zero, then shear force will be having zero slope line. So you can see on in these regions we have zero shear force. Now again, see, important thing is, now here we have shear force which is positive shear force constant. So if positive shear force constant, we will have positive bending moment slope line. Again here it is positive shear force constant. Here is again positive shear force constant. So in these regions we have positive slope bending moment line. Now here we can see negative shear force is constant. So if negative shear force is constant, so we have negative slope line. I hope you are getting the things. Now next one is when UDL is given. So when UDL is given, now we can see here the load intensity throughout is constant. So if from A to B load intensity is constant, so you can see we have drawn a positive slope line. Okay, now after that, when we are drawing the bending moment diagram, so we need to observe shear force value. Now we can see up to half portion shear force is reducing. So if shear force is reducing and shear force is in positive region, so when positive in when shear force is reducing in positive region, so slope will be reducing from higher to zero value. Now you can see at point C the shear force becomes zero and here it was having plus 12 value. So between region A and C you'll have to draw a curve in such a way that slope will be in decreasing mode and it will reach final to the zero value. So you can say here we have some slope value. Now after reaching at the top we'll have zero slope. Because why? Because shear force becomes zero, because we have a relation dm by dx is equal to f. Here at this point f becomes zero, so dm by dx slope will become zero. Now after that, negative shear force increasing as we move towards B point, so here negative slope will get increased. So this is how the conceptual things are there. Now next we move to the cantilever. We have simply supported beam with a UVL, uniformly varying load. So most of the students are confused here how we can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram for this UVL case. See, very important thing I told you, when we are drawing shear force diagram, so we'll have to check the load intensity. Now here we can see load while moving from A to B is load intensity is increasing. So when we are moving A to B while drawing shear force diagram, so we'll have to make shear force diagram in such a way that its slope will increase. So here we can see we have drawn in such a way. Now here the slope is less, here the slope is more, and here the slope is again more. So we can see because from moving A to B we can see load intensity is increasing. It is like this. So slope is increasing. Although shear force is decreasing, but we have to make a curve line in such a way which will be parabolic such that slope will increase. Now if in the same case UVL is given, suppose UVL is given like this, then how we'll do that? How we'll draw this line? See, so line will be parabolic, but it will be in the different form. See here, if we are given this case where load intensity is reducing, so let's have equation df by dx is equal to w. So if load intensity is reducing, so in that case slope will be in reducing nature. So we will draw it is like this. Now you can say while moving from here to here, now slope is reducing and finally it is like this. So this is how the variation of shear force diagram will occur in case of UVL. Now come to the bending moment diagram. See, again for drawing the bending moment diagram we need to observe shear force diagram. Now in this case it is similar. So we can see it is positive shear force which is reducing. So we'll have to draw a positive slope curve such that the value approaches to zero slope, because here shear force becomes zero. So again in the similar way it will be like this, and here now negative shear force increasing, so we will draw a curve such that negative slope will increase. So this is how we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram for UVL case. So again similar here we can have, now there is point load given on the cantilever. So whenever there is point load, we can observe shear force diagram will be rectangular in nature. So we got rectangular shear force diagram and bending moment diagram will be minus. Why here it is minus? Because we are having hogging condition here after bending. Now next is UDL, uniformly distributed load. Again in the same case here we have UDL. So UDL means W intensity is constant. So if W is constant, so df by dx will be constant. Constant means, so we have drawn a constant slope line here, right? Now we can see positive shear force is reducing. So if shear force reducing, then dm by dx will also reduce. So you can see we have drawn this curve. Now this curve from moving this point to toward this point, we can see slope is reducing. How you can observe this? Here we have this slope, there we have this slope, and finally here we have zero slope. Why we have here zero slope? Because here the shear force become zero. So this is how bending moment diagram will change. Now next is this overhanging beam case. Again in the similar way we have drawn shear force and bending moment diagram. You can observe here, now we got this bending moment diagram. So you can see this is a point or section. On the left side of this we have complete shear force diagram positive, and on the right side we have complete shear force diagram, sorry, not shear force diagram, bending moment diagram. On the left side of this section we have completely positive bending moment diagram, on the right side of this we have completely negative bending moment diagram. And as we know, when we consider positive bending moment, when we have sagging, and negative bending moment means hogging. So by the bending moment diagram we can observe how the beam shape will be after bending or after this load condition. So how can observe? Now you can see, let project this section to the top of the beam. So we have projected this one. So on the left side of this we have positive. Positive means we will have beam shape after bending like this. And on the right side of this section we have negative bending moment. So negative bending moment will be, so we'll have beam section like this. So this is how we can predict that how the beam shape will be after loading by taking these load conditions on the beam which is overhanging. Now next is this one. This you can observe, there is a overhanging beam which is overhanging on the both side, and we have drawn shear force and bending moment diagram. So this is very important. Most of the student ask that in this region we have drawn bending moment. See, let I magnify this. We have drawn bending moment like this. So students are asking why we cannot draw the bending moment over this section like this. See, there is a conceptual thing, and that conceptual thing is depend upon again dm by dx is equal to f. So let's start with, so here we can see in this portion, sorry, here we see in this portion shear force in negative value increasing. So while making the bending moment diagram we need to observe shear force diagram. So here in the shear force diagram, negative value of shear force increasing. So let's we have dm by dx is equal to f, slope is reducing in negative. So we'll have to make a line here in bending moment diagram in such a way that negative slope will increase. And how we can show the line curve such that negative slope will increase? So that will be like this one. So this is how we have drawn bending moment curve here like this. Because if we'll draw bending moment here like this, here the slope which is negative will what? You can see here negative shear force is increasing. So we'll have to make line such a way that slope will increase in negative way. But if we'll draw line curve like this, so here the slope is, you can say, decreasing, negative slope decreasing. So it is wrong. So we'll have to join by, sorry, like this. So this is how we have drawn here. Now next is, we can see here positive shear force is decreasing. So we'll have to make curve during this portion such a way that slope will decrease. So we have drawn like this. Again negative shear force increasing, so negative slope should increase. So this is how we have made curve during this region. Again this is similar to this one. So here we have drawn like this, again we have to draw like this here. So this is how bending moment diagram will change its sign. Now these are some salient features of the shear force and bending moment diagram which are very important, which should be always in mind. So first point is, shear force diagram will be rectangular in case when only point load is given. This you can see by seeing the diagram which is 3.13. If you remember, there was on the cantilever, there was only point load which had at a free end. So in that case, we got shear force diagram which was rectangular. Next is point number 2. Shear force diagram will be triangular in case when only UDL is given. So for this, you can refer a question where complete UDL is given on the simply supported beam. So in that case, shear force diagram will be triangular in nature. Next is shear force diagram will be parabolic under UVL. So you can refer, for this point, you can refer a UVL load given on the simply supported beam. Next point is bending moment will be triangular in case when only point load is given. You can refer a first question where this beam was given and at the center point there was a concentrated load. So in that case, bending moment diagram will be triangular in nature. Again, next point number 5 is bending moment will be parabolic curve under UDL. This you know already. Next is bending moment diagram will be cubic curve under UVL. This you already know. How we can say these things? As per according to the bending moment equations in terms of x we got. Next, point number 7 is shear force will have two values at a point where point load is given. See, this is very important. You have observed, like in case of point load, so whenever there was point load, so we have observed at that point there was always two value of shear force. Like here, suppose this is RA reaction, so here we have two values, 0 as well as plus 26. Now there is again point load which is RA. So here we have minus 14 as well as plus 4. Here we have point load. Here again we have two value of shear force. One is plus 4, one is 0. So keep remember always, whenever we have point load, so at that point we will always get two values of shear force in shear force diagram. Now next and the last is point number 8. Bending moment will be having maximum value where shear force will change its sign in between the beam. That you know, always we use this point to get the bending moment maximum in between the beam while drawing bending moment diagram. Next one is shear force diagram of cantilever will be positive in case fixed end on the left side and free end on the right side. This you will always get when you will follow sign convention given by me. So if you will follow sign convention given by me, so you will always get this positive shear force diagram whenever there will be fixed end on the left side and free end on the right side in the case of cantilever. Next, point number 10 is shear force diagram will be always negative if the fixed end will be on the right side and free end will be on the left side. This you can check by yourself. So whatever problem you have done where you have taken fixed end on the left side, so let's take fixed end on the right side and the same loading condition. So if you will draw shear force diagram, you will get negative shear force diagram in the same case. Now point number 11, which one is the last, point of contrafracture is generally observed in overhanging beam. So this we have earlier done in the last lecture number 10, where in the case of overhanging beam we are getting point of contrafracture. Now what is point of contrafracture? It is the point in between the beam where bending moment changing its sign either from positive to negative or negative to positive. So this is all about the concept behind shear force and bending moment diagrams. Hope you have learned a lot of things from this lecture. Thank you very much.